In the name of Lord Jesus Christ, I speak.
奉主是圣名在这里正道。
First and foremost, I give thanks to our Heavenly Father for enabling us to attend tonight's service online.
首先，我们感谢神，让我们能够在今天晚上能够来参加线上的聚会。
We know that we have to join in service regularly. And simply because we need the word of God to encourage us.
那我们知道呢，我们需要常常来听神的道理呢，是因为我们必须要常常的被神的话来浇灌。
We understand that without the word of God, we can never survive the onslaught of the corruptions from the world.
如果我们不被神的话来，我们不常常的聆听神的话，那我们就会被世上的这些世俗来影响，来败坏。
If the word of God is not kept in the heart, we'll begin to realize that our hearts will become corrupt as well.
那如果我们不把神的话记在心里的话，那我们的心也会被败坏。
We know that whoever speaks must also speak from a heart of sincerity.
那讲到的也要从这个真诚的心来，从心来讲出来。
He must speak with the intention of first wanting to teach himself.
那讲到的呢，也要首先要被神的话来教导。
So as for the listeners, they must come to listen with a heart of reverence towards God.
那些聆听的呢，也要用一个敬畏神的心来聆听。
Only then we find that we can be mutually encouraged.
那唯有这样呢，我们才能够互相的来鼓励。
Thank God that tonight I'm going to continue with our topic, the story of Rehoboam.
今天我们继续。查考的主题是罗伯安的故事。
We know that the name Rehoboam means to set the people at liberty.
我们知道罗伯安这个名字的意思呢，就是要使人民自由。
So you find that this king here is like was given a very important task to carry out.
那所以这个王其实是被神来。要来委以重任的。
His mission is to set his people free from any form of bondage.
那他的使命呢，就是要让神的人、神的百姓呢，能够从捆绑中得释放。
He must be able to bring God's liberty to his people.
那要让神所给予的自由能够把它带给人、带给百姓。
So that the people of God can be freed from idolatry.
所以使神的百姓呢，能够从敬拜偶像当中，能够在敬拜偶像当中能够来得释放。
Can be freed from the adverse influences of the surrounding nations.
那也会在被其他，也会在在被其他的这些国家的人民来影响，从中得释放。
So, you know, he is tasked with a very heavy responsibility.
所以呢，这个王呢是背负一个非常重要的一个任务。
We mentioned last week that he had not lived up to the meaning of his name.
可是从上个星期呢，我们就知道罗伯安其实没有他没有把神的话呢来。付出于行动。
The meaning of his name was not lived up.
那他没有活出他的名字的意思的这个生活。
We know that he was the last king of the united Israel before the nation split into two.
那我们知道呢，罗伯安是在以色列国分成两个国家的之前的最后一个王。
So we mentioned about, you know,when his father died, he consulted the elders, you know, concerning the request presented to him by the people.
我们知道呢，从上个星期的道理中知道呢，罗伯安其实没有来跟从这他父亲的这些所委任的长老里面的这些劝勉呢，来跟服从他们的劝勉。
Instead, you find that he also consulted those who grew up together with him.
那他其实也向那些跟他一起从小一起长大的一些人来询问。
So instead of listening to the elders, he decided to reject their advice and heeded the suggestions from his peers.
那他不但没有聆听这些长老的给的劝勉，他反而来拒绝。可是呢，他也聆听，他也听从他那些发小的这些给他的这些意见。
So as a result, he inflicted a harsher treatments upon the people of God.
所以呢，他就做出一些对神的百姓更残忍的一些事情。
So you find that they lost faith altogether.
我们就发现了之后呢，这些百姓呢都对神失去了信心。
I want you to read just to refresh our memory. We turn to chapter 10, verse 16.
我们来看历代志下第
Chapter 10, verse 16.
历代志下10章16节。
Verse 16.
16节。
And now, when all Israel saw that the king did not listen to them, the people answered the king, saying, What share have we in David? We have no inheritance in the son of Jesse. Every man to your tents, O Israel. Now see to your own house, O David.
Which book?
Second Chronicles chapter 10, verse 16.
历代志下10章16节，以色列众民见王不依从他们，就对王说：“我们与大卫有什么份儿呢？与耶西的儿子并没有关涉。以色列人呐，各回各家去吧，大卫家自己顾自己吧。”
His action has caused faithlessness in the people of God.
那罗伯安的行为呢，其实是让神的百姓呢对神失去信心。
They no longer trusted in the promise of David.
那他们不再相信神对大卫的应许。
So you see that they lost hope altogether.
那所以呢，他们就失去对神的信心。
The lesson that we have learned is that sometimes the wrong advice, if we receive it, can cause a lot of confusion to us and also to our faith.
那我们学到的教训就是，当我们聆听错误的勉励的时候，那我们就会造成教会很多的混乱。
So and also we see that from then on, the house of David was always in conflict with the nation of Israel.
那我们也发现呢，在大卫的家中呢，其实有很多不法的事情的发生。
We read verse 19.
你看19节。
Chapter 10, verse 19.
10章19节。
And so Israel has been in rebellion against the house of David to this day.
19节，这样以色列人背叛大卫家，直到今日。
So it's like, the actions of Rehoboam created enmity between the house of David and also the nation of Israel.
然后在这里就看到呢，因为罗伯安所做的行动呢，使到大卫家和以色列人呢成为敌对的。
So you find that there was no freedom to the people.
所以对百姓来说，他们是没有得到自由。
But throughout his life, the nation has been in battle against the nation of Israel.
所以在罗伯安在世的时候呢，以色列人和大卫家的人呢，一直在征战。
We can imagine how much pain he has caused to his own people.
我们可以想象呢，罗伯安这样的行动，对他自己家的人造成多大的伤害。
Now, we are going to look at the overall teachings that we can gather from Second Chronicles, from chapter 10 to chapter 12.
那我们今天来一起互相学习，我们从历代志下第九章到第十二章所学到的几点重要的教训。
We mentioned that, you know, the reason for him not to listen to the elders is because of fame and wealth.
那我们知道呢，罗伯安不听从这些长老的劝勉，是因为他自己的信心，还有他自己的财富。
Fame and wealth.
就是他自己的名利和财富。
And that caused a lot of trouble to his own people.
那他因为这样呢，所以造成很多以色列人的这些伤害。
So he, you know, on one occasion, he sent, a person in charge of revenue, you know, to go and collect money from the people.
那所以有一次呢，他就差派一个人呢，就到以色列人中呢来收取钱财。
We can read verse 18.
我们可以看18节。
Then King Rehoboam sent Hadoram, who was in charge of revenue, but the children of Israel stoned him with stones, and he died. Therefore, King Rehoboam mounted his chariot in haste to flee to Jerusalem.
18节，罗伯安差遣掌管服苦之人的哈多兰往以色列人那里去，以色列人就用石头打死他。罗伯安王急忙上车，逃回耶路撒冷去了。
So because of his action, you can see all sort of, how can I put it, crimes and sins are committed by the people.
因为他这样的行为呢，使到这些百姓呢，做了很多得罪神的事情。
We said, you know, as leaders of the church, we must be upright, so whatever we do must be right in the sight of God.
作为神家里带领信主的人呢，我们必须要 我们就要做神眼中看为对的事情。
We must not seek our own interest.
我们不可以要求自己的利益。
We must seek the interest of the house of God.
我们一定要求神家里的利益。
So after he had gone to Jerusalem, he started preparing himself to fight against Israel.
所以当罗伯安回到耶路撒冷的时候呢，他就想办法要来 对付以色列人。
We can see this in chapter 11.
我们可以从十一章看到。
But God spoke to him through a prophet.
可是呢，神借着一位先知呢来告诉罗伯安。
We read chapter 11 verse 4.
我们看十一章第四节。
Chapter 11 verse 4, thus says the Lord, you shall not go up or fight against your brethren. Let every man return to his house, for this thing is from me. Therefore, they obeyed the words of the Lord and turned back from attacking Jeroboam.
第四节，耶和华如此说：你们不可上去与你们的弟兄征战，各归各家去吧，因为这事出于我。众人就听从耶和华的话，归回，不去与耶罗伯安征战。
You find that here is like, you know, he listened to the word of the Lord. After he returned to Jerusalem, he also started building up his military.
可是当他回到耶路撒冷的时候呢，他就开始建造一些军队。
We can see this clearly in chapter 11.
我们可以从十一章里面清楚的看到。
I want you to drop down to chapter 12.
我们看十二章。
Chapter 12, we look at verse 1.
十二章第一节。
Verse 1, now it came to pass when Rehoboam had established the kingdom and had strengthened himself, and he forsook the law of the Lord and all Israel along with him.
第一节，罗伯安的国建立。 他强盛的时候，就离弃耶和华的律法，以色列人也都随从他。
You find that when he became strong and he decided to turn his back on God and his commandments.
所以我们发现当罗伯安的国建立的时候呢，他就离弃神和他神的律法。
We have to question, why did he do that?
我们就是要问为什么他这样做呢？
When God first told him, you know, not to attack, he listened.
是之前神告诉他不要攻击的时候，他听从了。
But here, when he became strong, he refused to adhere to the law of God.
可是之后，当他的国建立起来的时候，那他就离弃，不听从神的话。
And the chapter 12, verse 1 clearly tells us that he forsook the law of the Lord.
第一节就很清楚告诉我们，他就离弃耶和华的律法。
Now, the question is, in what way do you think he has forsaken the law?
所以他是在什么事情上离弃了神呢？
I want you to turn to 1 Kings chapter 14.
看列王记上十四章。
1 Kings chapter 14.
列王记上十四章。
All right, I want you to read from verse 22.
二十二节。
14 verse 22.
十四章二十二节。
Now Judah did evil in the sight of the Lord, and they provoked him to jealousy with their sins, which they committed more than all that their fathers had done.
二十二节，犹大人行耶和华眼中看为恶的事，犯罪触动他的愤恨，比他们列祖更甚。
Verse 23.
二十三节。
For they also built for themselves high places, sacred pillars, and wooden images on every high hill and under every green tree.
二十三节，因为他们在各高冈上、各青翠树下筑坛，立柱像和木偶。
Verse 24.
24节。
And there were also perverted persons in the land that did according to all the abomination of the nations which the Lord had cast out before the children of Israel.
24节，国中也有孕童，犹大人效法耶和华在以色列人面前所赶出的外邦人，行一切可憎恶的事。
We mentioned that when a person is to be enthroned as the king of Israel, he must first copy a set of the law of Moses.
那我们知道呢，当一个人被高成为王的时候呢，他必须要呢来抄录一份神的律法。
Rehoboam was given the authority and power to control the nation.
那罗伯安呢就被赋予呢这些能够管理百姓的这个权利。
But he did not, you know, stop the people from sinning against God by introducing idolatry to the nation.
可是他没不但没有阻止百姓，反而他更让这些其他的这些外邦人的神呢来进入到百姓中百姓里面。
No wonder in Second Chronicles chapter 12 verse 1, we are told that he has forsaken the law of the Lord.
所以呢，在历代志下十二章第一节呢，就说到他是离弃了神的律法。
So we must ask, you know, what has influenced him so negatively?
所以我们必须要问说，为什么事情呢，使到这么影响他
？When you see that someone has fallen away from the grace of God, there must be reasons behind.
那当我们看见一个人如果是从神的恩典之中流逝的话，那我们就要问为什么。
When you see that someone is drifting away from God, there must be reason, there must be forces that are pushing him away from the Lord.
那当一个人如果在神的话语中流逝的话，那我们就要知道是什么原因让他流失在神的话语当中。
So I think, you know, we can identify some reasons based on Second Chronicles chapter 10 to 13.
那所以我们在历代志下第十章到第十二章里面可以看到这些原因。
And we understand that he was the son of Solomon.
我们也明白罗伯安是所罗门王的儿子。
We know that Solomon, you know, towards the end of his life, he had not behaved wisely in the sight of God.
那我们知道呢，在所罗门王要离世之前呢，其实他是做了在神眼中看为恶的事。
I think judging from Second Chronicles chapter 11, he must have, followed, the example of his father.
那所以从历代志下11章，你能够看到呢，罗班其实跟从他父亲的脚步。
We question, how do we know?
那我们就问说，为什么我们会知道呢？
We turn to Second Chronicles.
我们看历代志下。
If you read from chapter 11, verse 18, to the end of the chapter.
你看，历代志下11章18节到23节。
Here it gives a very brief introduction to his family and his background of the family.
那这里的就简单描述到了罗伯安的家世。
It's about him marrying different women.
那这里就提到罗伯安其实娶了不同的人为妻，
So he was pretty similar to the father.
所以他就好像他父亲一样。
You find that the downfall of the father is because he had married too many foreign women.
所以他父亲的败坏是因为他父亲娶了许多不同的女子为
And
妻。
many of those so-called concubinal, concubinary wives, were actually foreigners who worship idols.
那所以这所罗门王的这些妾室呢，其实是导致了所罗门王敬拜其他神的原因。
Now, when you look at this Rehoboam, he also married many women.
那在我们看罗伯安的时候呢，其实他也娶了许多女子为妻。
We said this is a kind of life that can corrupt a person.
其实这样的生活是能够败坏一个人的。
They emphasize so much on pleasure of the flesh.
那他们注重许多在生活上或者是属肉体的这些快乐。
We understand that for a person to stand strong in the Lord, he is required to curb himself. And to know how to control himself in his life.
那当我们说一个属灵的人呢，是必须要在生活上有节制。
We find that this is a huge challenge to us as well.
我们发现呢，这对我们是一个非常大的挑战。
So from here, we say that he has learned the example of his father.
那所以我们从这里就知道呢，罗伯安其实是学习了他父亲。
I think we can derive a very important teachings for ourselves and for the younger generation to come.
那所以呢，对我们还有对那些对之后的人来说，之后的后代来说呢，是非有一个非常重要的教训。
We understand that every action that we take will affect our family or people around us either. Profitably or adversely.
我们知道我们的行为呢，会带来不管是好的行为或者是坏的行为呢，会对我们之后我们周围的人带来影响。
We must do our best with the help of God, always, to exert positive influence on people around us.
所以我们要依靠神呢，来让我们的行为呢，能够来在。我们对我们周围的人呢，来赋予一个好的影响。
You find that the unfaithfulness of Solomon not only has caused his own downfall, in fact he has also caused the downfall of his children, and in fact many generations to come.
所以所罗门的不忠心呢，来导致了他的后代呢，来对来呃不。来离弃神。
Now the second reason is also in Second Chronicles. We can turn to Second Chronicles chapter 12.
我们看历代志下第十二章。
We turn to Second Chronicles chapter 12.
历代志下十二章。
I guess the Bible will not state something without, without reason or without a reason.
那我们知道呢， 圣经呢不会在没有原因之下呢来抄录或者是记录一件事情的发生。
We read chapter 12, verse 13.
你看历代志下12:13。
And thus King Rehoboam strengthened himself in Jerusalem and reigned. And now Rehoboam was 41 years old when he became king, and he reigned 17 years in Jerusalem, the city which the Lord had chosen out of all the tribes of Israel to put his name there. Now, the last part is it talks about the mother, right? His mother's name was Naamah, and Ammonitis.
13节，罗伯安王自强，在耶路撒冷作王。他登基的时候年41岁，在耶路撒冷，就是耶和华从以色列众支派中所选择立他名的城，作王17年。罗伯安的母亲名叫拿玛，是亚门人。
We know that, like what we have stated early on, Solomon married many women.
我们知道呢，之前已经说提到了所罗门王娶了非常多的妻子，
Many of them were foreigners, they were idol worshippers.
很多的妻子呢是其实是敬拜其他神的人。
These women not only did not turn to the Lord, they led Solomon astray.
那这些妻子呢不但没有来敬畏神，反而他们来导致了所罗门王敬拜外邦神的原因。
Here, the mother of Rehoboam actually is an Ammonitess.
所以罗伯安的母亲是一个亚门人。
So obviously, the mom must have a very negative influence on him as well.
那所以罗伯安的母亲呢，是对罗伯安造成一个非常不好的原，造成他非常不好的影响。
You can imagine, for someone to grow up in such an environment, and obviously, he would become corrupt.
那我们可以想象，当一个人生活在这样的影响之下呢，那这个人会变得很非常的败坏。
Now, also, you find that people with whom he mingled, they were also corrupt.
那我们也能够看见呢，罗伯安呢，跟其他的他所与他们一同来往的呢，都是非常败坏的人。
We can turn back to chapter 10 of Second Chronicles.
你看《历代志下》第10章，
Second Chronicles chapter 10.
《历代志下》10章。
It seems that he had a close companion, the people of his age.
那我们能够看到呢，罗伯安其实有他很好的同伴。
Now, but we find that, these young people did not respect God.
可是这些他的同伴呢，其实是不尊敬畏神的。
If you look at the advice, given by this young man, this young people to Rehoboam, then we can conclude that, they didn't really respect anyone.
那当我们看到这些少年人的时候呢，他们其实是没有敬畏神的。
You find that obviously in their hearts, there was no God.
所以呢，在他们心里是没有神的。
We can read verse 10.
看第10节。
Verse 10, then the young man who had grown up with him spoke to him, saying, Thus you should speak to the people who have spoken to you, saying, Your father made your yoke heavy, but you make it lighter on us. Thus you shall say to them, My little finger shall be thicker than my father's waist.
第10节，那同他长大的少年人说，这名对王说：“你父亲使我们负重轭，求你使我们轻松些。”王要对他们如此说：“我的小拇指比我父亲的腰还粗。
Verse 11.
”11节。
And now, whereas my father put a heavy yoke on you, I will add to your yoke. My father chastised you with whips, but I will chastise you with scourges, with scorpions.
11节，我父亲使你们负重轭，我必使你们负更重的轭。我父亲用鞭子责打你们，我要用楔子鞭策打你们。
You can see how heartless, this young people were.
啊，我们可以从这些少年人所说的话当中看见，他们是没有心的。
They show no respect to, to the people of God.
那他们对百姓呢是没有来尊重的。
Rehoboam, mingle with these people.
那所以罗伯安呢是跟这些少年人一起。
No wonder he became corrupt as well.
那所以呢，不可厚非的，他变得非常的败坏。
So the Bible also tells us that, bad company corrupts a good character.
我们知道呢，当我们有坏，滥交是败坏的开始。
We must choose our friend choice, must be wise, must be based on the principle of God. We have to be wise in choosing our friends.
所以我们在选择朋友当中呢，要非常的谨慎。
All right. Now, I also want you to turn to Second Chronicle chapter 12.
你看《历代志下》十二章。
Second Chronicle chapter 12.
历代志下十二章。
All right. We read verse 14, right?
看十四节。
12:14.
十四节。
This is like, how can I say, a summary given to the life of Rehoboam.
所以这一节呢，就大概的简单的讲述了罗伯安一生。
We read verse 14.
看十四节。
And he did evil because he did not prepare his heart to seek the Lord.
十四节，罗伯安行恶，因他不立定心意，寻求耶和华。
This is how the writer describes, the entire life of Rehoboam in a very summarized form.
那这就是这本书的作者呢，来用这句话呢来形容罗伯安的一生。
It's about the heart.
那是关于罗伯安的心。
We said. We cannot see the hearts of others very easily, but we know our hearts ourselves.
那我们可能说我们不能够来看，能够看见其他人的心思，可是我们非常清楚的认知到自己的心意。
God knows our heart the best.
那神非常的清楚我们的心意。
So he fell, it is because his heart was not, he has not set right his heart before God.
那所以神知道呢，罗伯安没有把他的心意呢来立定。
Actually, God has given him the chances to change and transform as well.
那其实神已经给了罗伯安机会呢，要来让使他能够来改变自己。
There is an incident, given in chapter 11 that we can look at more closely.
这件事，所以这样，我们能够在十一章看到这样的机会。
So you find that when Jeroboam was the king of the northern kingdom.
那我们知道呢，当耶罗伯安是北朝的王的时候。
From verse 13 onward, we see that all the Levites, they all came to the south.
十三节就提到呢，以色列全地的祭司和利未人都从四方归罗伯安。
We read the verse 13, right?
十三节。
And from all their territories, the priests and the Levites who were in all Israel took their stand with him. For the Levites, 14. For the Levites left their common lands and their possession and came to Judah and Jerusalem, for Jeroboam and his son had rejected them from serving as priests to the Lord. Verse 13 and 14.
十三节，以色列全地的祭司和利未人都从四方来归罗伯安。十四节， 利未人撇下他们的郊野和产业，来到犹大与耶路撒冷，是因耶罗波安和他的儿子拒绝他们，不许他们供祭司职分，侍奉耶和华。
We find that the good Levites, the good priests, came down to the south.
所以那些好的祭司和利未人呢，都从四方来归，来到南边。
We also understand that, you know, the king of Judah must also consult, you know, the priest and the Levite in religious matters.
那我们也知道呢，在南部呢，其实这些祭司和利未人呢，都会要来询问关于这些敬畏神的事情。
But it seems that, you know, he was not influenced or guided, you know, by the priest and the Levites.
可是呢，我们发现罗伯安其实没有来被这些神的祭司和利未人来带领。
So it all goes to show that his heart was not right before God.
所以我们就知道呢，其实他的心呢是在神面前是不正的。
There may be moments, you know, in his life that he wanted to trust in God.
可能在他的生活当中呢，有一小部分其实是他有信靠神的，
Only for a short while.
可是只是一短暂的时候。
And then he would turn his back on God and follow his own desire.
可是之后呢，他又把他的背来向神呢，来寻求自己的利益。
And so here it teaches us that our heart is important.
所以这里告诉我们呢，我们的心是非常重要的。
We must do whatever we can to ensure that our heart is right before God is kept well within the remits of the Word of God.
我们要尽我们的所能呢，要来把我们的心意呢，就坚定的立定向神。
Otherwise, you find that you know you we can swept away easily by bad influences.
那否则呢，我们会因为这些不好的这些事情呢，来影响我们，要来从神的话当中来，水流失去。
I want to share with you a very commonly spoken verse, that is Proverbs chapter 4.
我们要跟大家分
，verse 23.
跟大家分享一个经节，箴言第四章二十三节。
Verse 23.
四章二十三节。
Keep your heart with all diligence, for out of it spring the issues of life.
二十三节，你要保守你心，胜过保守一切，因为一生的果效是由心发出。
How do we keep the heart?
我们如何来保守我们的心呢
？When you read the following verses, they teach us how to keep our hearts.
当我们接着念的时候，就告诉我们如何的要来保守我们的心。
Put away from you a deceitful mouth.
你要除掉邪僻的口。
And put perverse lips far from you.
弃绝歪谬的嘴。
Our words, you know, represent what is in the heart.
那我们所说的话语呢，其实代表我们心中所想的。
So sometimes we speak words of pride.
那有的时候我们会说出骄傲的话语。
We speak words of jealousy.
我们会说出一些嫉妒的话。
We speak words to cause confusion and division in family and in the church.
我们也会说出让家里人或者是让教会呢产生混乱的一些话。
We speak unclean words.
我们说出不洁净的话语。
So when we analyze the word that we have spoken,
那当我们来反省、思考我们所说出的话
then we know that many a time we have fallen short of the required standard of God.
那所以很多时候呢，其实我们会发现我们已经来没有来没有来遵照神要我们所说的话语的这个这这样的一个。
神的标准
啊，神的标准。
Just like Rehoboam, he did not speak the words which were good to the listeners, good to the people.
就好像罗伯安一样，没有把这些好的 从神来的话语呢，来告诉百姓一样。
Now, verse 25, we turn back to Proverbs 4:25.
我们看箴言书四章二十五节。
Let your eyes look straight ahead and your eyelids look right before you.
二十五节，你的眼目要向前正看，你的眼睛当向前直观。
Meaning that what we look at can also influence our thinking as well.
那这就告诉我们呢，那当我们看我们眼睛所看见的事情，也会影响我们所想的。
Verse 25 teaches us that we must be pure in our eyes as well.
那二十五节就告诉我们，我们的眼目要清洁。
Otherwise, we can also be enticed by sin.
否则的话呢，我们也会被罪来捆绑。
Now, also, if you look at verse 26, ponder the path of your feet and let all your ways be established.
二十六节，要修平你脚下的路，坚定你一切的道。
Do not turn to the right or to the left. Remove your foot from evil.
二十七节，不可偏向左右，要使你的脚离开邪恶。
You know, this feet or path represents our behavior, the things that we do.
那所以脚下的路呢，就是代表了我们的行为，或者是我们所做的一切事情。
So it must be right in the eyes of God.
那所以这些呢，都是要在神面前、行神面前看为正的事情。
So when we write our actions with the word of God, then our heart shall be kept.
那当我们在我们所行的事上呢，来达到神的标准的时候，那我们就能够保守我们的心。
Also in the story of Rehoboam, we can learn great lessons about the principles of God.
在罗伯安的那么从罗伯安身上也能够学习到神的原则。
We know that God is a righteous God.
我们知道神是公义的神。
I want you to turn back to 2 Chronicles chapter 12.
你看历代志下十二章。
Rehoboam transgressed against the Lord.
当我们知道呢，当罗伯安呢来不遵守神命令的时候
，God allowed this. God actually raised up, the Egyptian king, Shishak, to attack them.
所以呢，神呢就使埃及王示撒上来攻击耶路撒冷。
But Rehoboam responded with a heart of humility. He humbled himself before God.
所以，可是那时候呢，罗伯安呢就来谦卑自己在神面前。
If we can see this in verse 6.
我们能够在第六节能够看到。
In verse 7, here it says about the response of the Lord.
第七节呢，就告诉我们神之后的反应。
And now when the Lord saw that they humbled themselves, the word of the Lord came to Shemaiah, saying, they have humbled themselves, therefore I will not destroy them, but I will grant them some deliverance. My wrath shall not be poured out on Jerusalem by the hand of Shishak.
第七节，耶和华见他们自卑，耶和华的话就临到示玛雅说，他们既自卑，我必不灭绝他们，必使他们略得拯救，我必不借着示撒的手将我的怒气倒在耶路撒冷。
So God has promised to give them some sort of deliverance.
那所以呢，神就答应给他们略得拯救。
So when the Egyptian king king came and he took away all the shield of gold which were made by Solomon.
那所以当埃及王示撒上来攻击耶路撒冷的时候呢，他就拿了这些金盾牌。
And later on, this king here, Rehoboam, he made some bronze shield.
之后呢，罗伯安就制造了铜盾牌。
Why does the Bible mention this specifically?
可是为什么在圣经当中特别记载这件事情呢？
You know, protection comes from the Lord, not come from how strong your army is.
我们知道呢，神的保守呢是从是不是从百不是从军队带来的，而是神的手。
When you look at chapter 11, you know, this Rehoboam, he prepared himself very well, militarily.
可是我们看11章的时候呢，罗伯安呢就他就坚强，他就建立了他的军队。
But you know, when this king came, there was no match for the king.
可是呢，当埃及王来到的时候呢，这些军队呢没有能够来打败这个埃及王。
It teaches us that real protection comes from God.
那就教导我们真正的保守呢是从神而来的。
Today we know that the world is very uncertain.
我们知道呢，今天的世代是非常非常不安稳的。
It's like you can't really find a safe haven.
我们就好像不能够寻找一个非常安全的一个落脚地点。
But we say true safety, true protection comes from the Lord.
可是真正的平安，真正的保守呢，是从神而来的。
This is a lesson that we can learn from the work of God here in the life of Rehoboam.
所以这些呢，是我们能够从耶罗波安身上所学习到的。
We must really keep our hearts right, set our hearts aright before God.
那所以我们要把我们的心思呢，立定在神面前。
Thank God my sermon ends here.
感谢神，我的正道到此。
We sing a hymn to praise God, 179.